sentencing is a one-off situation. It is not a one-off situation. And as far as that, we're Murray River, it's on keeps until we get to the real satisfaction of answers that we need. We need answers and we need results. And so when we came home from the war in 1946, January, the colonel was ready to be dismissed. The whole of America took him. And he said to us, "One last order I give to you. Go back to your mountains, go back to your morale, go back to your people and be the Rangatira that you are." To 8 Battalion, dismissed. Well, the battalion is all gone now. There's only 2 of us left. And so, what I say, if it's the last thing I'm going to do, I'm going to carry out that order. And I hope that it carries on like I'm going. I've been the youngest fellow in the battalion. I just turned 19 the other day. And so don't be disheartened if they don't turn up. You'll all be on record. If they don't turn up, you'll be on record. And we'll have someone that we're going to be talking to. And it doesn't matter if they turn up or not. We're going to hold these courts until such time as our people are satisfied with the privileges in one country.
Good.
Before I start, I just want to show you the Mohi, Paramount Chief Mohi Tamaki Manakawa, whakapapa. Here, he was a Freemason for 50 years in Helensburg. Now, I'll just say it this way, that the Awaroa Magistrate, Native Magistrate Court, was shifted from Okeato Magistrate Court up north, and they started off the Manukau title and seized all the titles with a writ warrant. And so we're doing the same thing again today. We're issuing a writ of control and possession and property seizure warrant today, this book. There's 106 pages, and we're doing exactly what they did back then when they blew the place up in Purarareka and took the title down to Kohimarama, and Bundy is going to look after that side of the government, that British government that came there. He can fashion it in the way, but I'll keep him on track because I've got all that documents right here. The magistrate court that I have in its full entirety is all these books you see here, and they go into that briefcase over there. That's a magistrate court, portable, that can operate courts anywhere in the world. And I'll be running around the world with that. And they have a shortened version, which is that. This is legal. This book is legal. It is the acts of King William IV, 7 years only of acts, 1984 pages, and they are legal. We can pick any one of those because we haven't cut the contract off with the King in England, and we've got to go there to change it, amend it, or leave it as it is. But I'm going there with the Paramount Chief to replace the Queen as the head of the trust on this side and take over the trust that belongs to us. That's where all that revenue has gone missing, out of the King's Bench Court side. So they've helped themselves to the King's Bench Court and silenced the King. The King is no longer silent. They're away and operating from today legally on the Crown's business there in Auckland. So we have some competition now to match up to the plate, which we have the Naus to do it, the intelligence to do it, the whakapapa to do it, and the titles to the land, the native titles, the original native titles, starting from here in 1820 with the Freemasons and the Manukau chief, Tirawaitu Wharehere, that's been hidden away, and they kept that magistrate court is a bank. It is a bank, portable bank. When the captain gets off his ship, he's got the bank in the ship tied up with his leg. In the four corners of the earth, the 8-point star, the municipality of this hat, the sheriff, can see the land. If you see something wearing that hat, there's only one of them. So anybody qualifies to put that on their head. can do the same as what we're just about to do today. Okay, so we'll leave it to the lawyer. We'll go through the proper channels, how to seize land in the right way, commercial way, and a legal or formal way than protest or complaint from the public. So we're doing it. This whakapapa is the title. This is the native title that the British accepted. It's got the Rogans, the Manukaus, and the Wānoas tied up in it. They married them to get the title from the East Coast and from the Kaikara and up north through that chief. So we're going to park all this law up and leave it and carry on with who we are today. That's the main thing. Okay, so I just want to let you know, this is in this book, and we'll put that online. Well, it's online now. I'm going to go ahead with the court hearing now, and you'll see Herewini or Sheldon, his name on these documents is Sheldon Clark, as a Maori, is Herewini Karaka, but today he shall be Sheldon Clark, the Magistrate Chief Justice, Paramount Chief Justice, from his ancestors that did all these work in the old days in Hokianga. So Hokianga features quite a lot in this history before it went to Russell, or Hokianga, and down into Auckland. So we're dealing with the live today title to Auckland and the Crown's building. So I'm going to go straight to the Auckland Native Grand Jury Magistrate Court, New Zealand. That's what we're calling it here. We keep the marae quite separate from it because they could have called it Te Unga Waka, but we use the marae-based court hearings. This is a marae, and so this is the closest to One Tree Hill, where this title is. And it is only just the title, it's not the everything of everything. You still have your own whakapapa, and you don't have to follow this. The British follow this, and it's up here somewhere. The land still belongs to you, but in the commercial sense, we're taking that away from them and converting it back to the tangata whenua of the land today. So we can put that at rest. That's what I want to say about that. The spirit of this in their titles on this side. Now, I'm going to do this. We have, I'm calling this hearing today of my role to go to England and for Bundy and Mahi and Herewini to administer the Crown's land, the Moai Crown. We're talking about our own crown and King William's crown over there. King William's flag belongs to him, but we use its power because he gave it to us. Anybody else on this side's third party, and they've got a problem, Georgie will fix up the third party problem. And this two-party contract is still alive today. No one can tamper with it. That's what I'm saying. So I'm going to start off with it. I'm not going to go right through all the pages. I'm just only going up to the exhibits because it can go on the exhibits of who is who. But I'm just going to read out so far and then I'll tell you whose names are going on hearing today. It reads here, affidavit of truth and statement fact, 29th day of September 2017. Affidavit of truth and statement of fact, number one, I, John Kawani Tahaki of the House of New Zealand, Paramount Chiefs, being the undersigned, do solemnly swear and declare and depose, two, that I am competent to state the matters herein, and do take oath of the Moai Crown office here today to swear, I swear an oath of office to Paramount Chiefs Pungiheka, 1830, Kukaun, Tahiti, and Oriori, Tera Waikato, Pare, Terehere, Manakau, 1820, and King George IV, 1820, time memorial. And I swear an oath of office to Dutchman, King William III, King George III, and his sons, King George IV, King Ernest Augustus I, and King William IV of Westminster Parliament, UK, England. and I swear an oath of office to my ancestral Patrick Church Order, Cosgrove and Rogan, coat of arms in Belfast, Ulster, Northern Ireland, and my Wānawa Uata Tupuna in Tikitiki, St. Mary's Church, 1831, linked to Belfast 8-point star of St. Patrick's, municipalities of the 1834 State of Emergency, flag sovereign authority given by King William IV to the Paramount Chief, which we inherit his fortunes and prized possessions by these his presence in our two-party private contract partnership. And I swear an oath of office to St. Mary's Church, Edinburgh, enshrined in the Holy Grail linked to our St. Mary's Church in Tikiti and Whakawhitira Native Magistrate Court, Herewini Mount Hikarangi, East Coast to St. Mary's Church, Parnell, Auckland Sea, to Awaroa Native Magistrate Court, Helensville, to Okeato Native Magistrate Court, Kororarika, Russell Bay of Ireland, direct to Westminster Magistrate Court, Paddington, Westminster City, UK, England, Sir Philip Jones, First Lord of the Sea, of King William IV, Sovereign Authority, Jurisdiction, and the 1834 Flag of Admiralty, Training Bank, Maui Crown Bank Magistrate Court Partnership. And I swear an oath of office to the 13 chiefs who formed the 1834 Whakamanga Flag, British land deeds inside the Okeaka.